Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to start with grammar topic number 9, non-finite verbs. So before starting with non-finite verbs, let us understand the difference between finite verbs and non-finite verbs with examples. See the example, Geeta teaches in the school. Now the verb teaches. Second example, John and Divya teach in school. So the verb is teach. Third example, my mother taught in school. The verb is taught, right? Now you must have noticed that the word teach change its form in all the three sentences. Now, why is it so? Because in first sentence, the subject Geeta is third person singular. So we have added here es to the word teach. In second sentence, the subject is John and Diya, that is plural. So we have taken the original form of verb, that is teach. So in these two sentences, as the subject changes from singular to plural, the form of verb also changes, right? See, in third sentence, my mother taught. Taught is the past tense of teach. So now here, in second example, the verb is teach, and in third example, the verb is taught. Now it has changed the form due to change in the tense. So the verbs which change the form according to the subject or according to the tense, those verbs are called finite verbs. Let us understand with some more examples. He speaks the truth. Now subject is he, third person. So we have added s to the verb speak. The root form of verb is speak. Second example, I speak the truth. Now here, the verb is speak. Subject is I, that is first person singular. And in first example, he is third person. So as there is change in the person, the form of verb also change. Next example, we spoke the truth. Now here it is speak, and in here last sentence it is spoke, as the tense of the verb has changed. So the verb which changes according to the person or according to the tense, it is called as finite verb. Which verb? Finite verb. So let's see the definition. A verb that is limited by tense or number is a finite verb. Now if the tense changes, the verb also, the form of verb also changes. If the number of subject changes, that is from singular to plural, or if the person from first person to third person, so according to the change in the subject or according to change in the tense, the form of verb changes. So when the form of verb changes, that verb is called finite verb. Now let's see what is non-finite verb. See the example, many students enjoy dancing. Now here your main verb is enjoy and the other verb is dancing. Geeta enjoyed dancing. Here also the verb dancing. So now this verb did not change its form. See the third example. Dancing was the popular means of entertainment in the past. So this verb did not change its form. Now here see the subject, many students, it is plural, but the verb is dancing. In second sentence, Geeta is third person singular. Even then, this word did not change. In third example also, past tense is given, then also the verb did not change its form. So the verbs which are not limited by tense, which does not change its form according to the tense, or which does not change its forms according to the number of person, that verbs are called non-finite verbs. Let us see some more examples. The girl wants to play. Now see the verb to play. Now here the girl is third person singular. Then to, the form is to play. I want to play. Here it is first person singular and to play did not change. It is same. They wanted to play. Now here want, they wanted, that is past tense. But here also it is to play. So those verbs which do not change its form as per the change in the number of subject or as per the change in the tense, those verbs are called non-finite verbs. So let us see the definition. A verb that is not limited by tense or number is a non-finite verb. So I hope you have understood the difference between finite and non-finite verbs. Let us see the kinds of non-finite verbs. Now there are three kinds of non-finite verbs. First is infinitive, second is participle, and third is gerund. So we will learn all these three in detail one by one. So let's start with infinitives. What are infinitives? An infinitive is a plain form of verb consisting of two plus verb. When we add two to the plain form of verb or to the root form of verb, then that is called as infinitive. For example, to run. Now see here the verb is run. We have added to before it. So to run becomes an infinitive. Now the main verb is jump. We have added to. So to jump is an infinitive. Similarly, to see, to think, to be. So these are all infinitives because we have added to the plain form of verb. The infinitive shows purpose or intention. Now why do we use infinitive? Because this shows purpose or intention. Example, I went to the market to buy a pen. Now to buy, buy is a verb, before that we have added to, so to buy is infinitive. Now it shows the purpose, why I went to the market, what was the purpose? To buy a pen. Okay. An infinitive that is used without to is called a bare infinitive. Now I told you when we add to the verb, it is called as infinitive. But sometimes infinitives are also used without to. There is no need of adding to before the verb. So those verbs which do not take to before them, or those infinitives rather which do not take to before them, they are called bare infinitive. Bare means without. Example, help me clean my room. Now here the main verb is help. And clean is infinitive. It is used without to. Help me to clean my room. So you can say like that also. But here we have not added to. So this infinitive is called as bare infinitive. So the infinitive which is used without to, it is called as bare infinitive. Okay. Let's move ahead. Now what are the uses of infinitives? So infinitives can be used as a noun, as an adjective, or as an adverb. So infinitives can be used in any of these three forms. Okay, so let us see the examples. Infinitive is used as a noun. So how we can use infinitive as a noun? For example, I want to swim. Now here the infinitive is to swim. Now to swim is used as a noun. It comes in the place of object. So infinitive can come either in the place of subject or object. And the word which comes in the place of subject or object is a noun. So here to swim is a noun. Next example, we hope to win. To win is our infinitive. Again, it is a noun. Sarah loves to read. So what does Sarah love? To read. So to read is a is an infinitive which acts as a noun. Next example, to steal is a crime. Now to steal, here the infinitive is used in place of subject and it does the work of a noun. It functions as a noun. What is crime? To steal is a crime, right? Next example, to read is her hobby. Again here to read. So to read is the infinitive which is the subject of the sentence and which acts as a noun. Let's move ahead. Infinitives used as an adjective. Now how we can use infinitives as an adjective? So let's see. I have no time to play. I have no time to play. Now what do you mean by adjective? Adjective means the word which describes the word which describes the noun, right? Now here I have no time to play. So to play describes about the noun, that is time. That was a game to watch. Which game? Game to watch. So this is also an infinitive which acts as an adjective. Next example, I told you to wait. So this is also an infinitive which acts as an adjective. She has a book to read in her free time. So to read is an infinitive. Let's see ahead. So which are the infinitives that are used as an adverb? Adverb means the word which tells us more about the verb or adjective or another adverb, right? She reads to gain knowledge. Now to gain, she reads. Why? To gain. So reading is a verb. So to gain is the word which describes, which tells us about read. So here the infinitive acts as an adverb. We learn English to understand. Why we learn? To understand. So here also infinitive to understand acts as an adverb. Her voice is pleasant to hear. So it describes the adjective pleasant. So here also it acts as an adverb. The new soldiers were ready to listen and obey. To listen. It also acts an adverb. It tells more about the verb. So in this way, infinitives can be used as a noun, as an adjective, or as an adverb. Okay, so these are the uses of infinitives. So I hope you have understood the difference between finite and non-finite, and also you have understood what are infinitives. So remaining part we will learn in our next lecture. Thank you.